forgot to do something. Crud. I gotta go do that now. This stream is gonna be bad. Ready. What's up, guys? Oof. It's Loneliest Wolf by Choice here, and I think I'm at the end of Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. So let's see if that is the case. I feel like I'm on my way to something major, and I don't know if I am, so this is just me using my game knowledge.
Even for the Empire.
Hold on a second. There we go. This is bloody. Okay. Cross. There's a save point here, or a meditation circle. I don't know how much this is going to help me. Let's find the hell out. How are you guys doing today?
You're falling behind.
Locked door. We need BD-1.
Just what we need.
Hey, boy. Oh, this totally looks like a bloody boss room. There she is.
Here, PD.
That won't change anything.
Get back here. Buddy.
Not today.
Right here, bud. Petey, stim here.
Zord.
You won't be standing much longer.
Yeah, you're right. I'm not going to be standing much longer. And yes, just like the rest of my kind, I have been defeated. The one thing I do hate about this game is, dear Lord, these loading screens are a bit much. Loading screens are a bit much, and they're still popping. They just had an update today that supposedly fixed stability issues and bugs, but I don't know if that is true. Oh yeah, I didn't scan this. Okay, do your thing, BD.
You broke them, beat them down, and turned them to the dark side.
Hey there.
I'm going to enjoy ending. Stay still.
Here, buddy.
Don't fear. Going to regret that. I need help, bud. Need assist.
Oh, God.
They should have never
been. Yeah, oh, damn, she had to finish me off like that? Jeez Louise. That's, that was awful. Alright, let's try this again.
Thank you.
your head. Stay still.
Speedy,
I need help.
I saw what you've been through. You've experienced great suffering. It's not too late to let it go.
Let go? I'm stronger now because of the pain.
What all that?
I knew you'd come back for this. No, thank you. You'll never make it out of this place alive! Such poor aim. You'll pay dearly for that. Get back here.
None of that. Okay, maybe some of that.
Toss me one, BD.
It's fine.
Stay still. That won't change anything.
To do this. It's over, Trilla.
Nothing is ever truly over.
This fight is over. I know the darkness that is eating you up inside, and every day we choose to either feed it or fight it.
It's too late, sir.
No, it's not. I know the choices that I made took all your choices away, and I have failed you, Trilla. I failed you. And I am so very sorry.
Someone's about to get stabbed.
I've carried so much hate for you.
Oh, that is breathing I don't like to hear. I want to. Can I? I'd surrender. I'd gladly.
Yeah. Probably.
Oh no! This is Vader. I don't want to fight Vader. Oh Jesus! He just grabbed me. Just straight off rip. No. Deadly. Trained in the dark side of the Force, Vader governs over the Inquisitors. Inquisitorius. So he's just been here the entire time. He's just been chilling in the cut somewhere, just like.
Alright. I think we lost him. I'll make it. Seer. I won't fail you.
He's here.
Kid, you read me?
Yeah, we gotta go.
They're not responding.
They will. I am certain of it.
Breeze, I'm here. Heading towards the surface. Be ready. I have the holocron. See her. She didn't make it, Breeze.
Oh! No! No, Vader. You ain't gonna do this. No. Uh-oh.
surrender the holocron.
I'll never give it to you.
We shall see.
Oh, no! Make me stab myself. Or he stab me, rather.
I will let you take those children.
Jesus!
Such hatred. You would have made an excellent Inquisitor.
She's stronger than that. No! No!
Yes. Strong with the dark side.
Seer.
I can feel it inside of her.
Seer!
Stop! Seer. Stop!
Hey,
you're gonna...
Listen to me! You still have a choice. Kid. Cal.
See her. She's all right. She's all right. You too. You did it.
Yeah, I just had some organs welded. It's not a big deal. Seared.
Oh, we did. Careful. Where are they?
Well, they're out there.
Whoa, hold on. Wait a minute.
Sorry.
That was you in the water, wasn't it?
I'm glad you're okay. This one wouldn't leave your side.
Thank you.
Now what?
Well, Captain, this is the end of my charter. Your contract has been fulfilled. Thank you, Grease.
Well, if it's all the same to you, I was thinking that maybe I would stick around here and take you wherever you gotta go. Besides, the kid kinda looks up to me.
What about that?
We use it. To rebuild the Jedi Order.
The next generation of Jedi.
The Empire will be after them. Just like they're after us.
The lives of every child on that list will be forever changed.
Not by us. Their destiny should be trusted to the Force.
So what you're saying is I fought the entire time
so he
could be like, nah. Trust only in the Force. That's it, guys. You watch me play it from the very beginning, and you'll watch me play it to the end. And then there's a big gap in the middle. But thank you for watching. All in all I gotta say about the game is very good. Not like stellar or amazing, but fun to play. There are graphical issues and a few bugs that are in it, but they should be fixing those over time. I gotta say that gameplay-wise, it's very simplistic. They try to go with the very Dark Souls-esque gameplay style, but it's actually a lot more simplistic and a lot more forgiving than Dark Souls is. It felt a little, it felt like Sekiro light, because Sekiro has the same type of combat and the same type of gameplay style with it, but not too crazy. So I did have a blast. I did have fun. I really did enjoy it. But I don't think it'd be for everybody, especially if I know some people are just like, it looks all right, but I mean, people who are gonna overly critique the game and stuff like that will not like this game too much, or especially if they're like, I wanted to be like a Souls game. It's kind of like it, but it's a lot easier, and it's a lot gameplay wise it's not too too much like it. It's a little bit of weirdness with hit detection, but when it comes to out of all of the Souls series, the PvE hit detection in Dark Souls 2 is the weakest. So it kind of feels like the PvE on that. In Dark Souls 2's PvP is a little bit more spot on with a lot of stuff. If you want to play PvP in any of the Souls games, 2 is the best one. But PvE, going up against like computer enemies, is the weakest one. It feels sometimes a little bit like the PvE in Dark Souls 2. But I don't hate the game. Would I say it's worth $60? No. I would not say it's worth $60. I would say it's worth maybe right now, maybe $40. I would say if you can get it on sale for $40 or less, I say go for it. If you're a Star Wars fan, there's a lot of little things that are in the game that are for you. Especially the last part that I just played. That was, boy, Lord. Visually the game looks all right. It looks a little dated. Also, there's a lot of pop in. I did the update today. I hadn't played it in about a week and a half, 2 weeks. There was an update automatically for it. So I was like, all right, cool, whatever. Do the update. Did the update. And when I got into the game, it was loading textures for about a minute and a half, which I was like, ew. Like, I didn't move just so I could see it. Like, I'm like, this looks like it's super untextured. And then it was slowly pop in, like, layer after layer after layer of texture, which I was like, yikes, guys. You kind of should, you should have, you quality assurance people that just passed up the screen, you guys should have been more on point with that stuff. All the actors in it that played in it did a really, really good job. I liked what's his name from Gotham, who's the main character, the main character in this game, but not the main character in Gotham. He's he's the Joker. He's the Joker. I don't remember what his name is. But it's definitely something to pick up. I'm trying to think of the actor's name. Good Lord, Cameron Monaghan. He's very good as Cal Kestis. I love me Deborah Wilson. Deborah Wilson, low key, is a great actress. As a seer, she was great. Daniel Roebuck as Grease was really cool. Elizabeth Gruyon as Trilla was awesome. Tina Ivlev, who did Night Sister Marin, was really good as well. Tony Amendola did Eno Cordova. And his parts are like the
the puzzle piece parts that he was giving you along the way was really, really cool. And Travis Willingham doing the voice of Jarl T'Pol. Travis Willingham being one of the experts, or the experts, one of the veterans of the voice actor community, was really, really good. Game, the acting side of the game was really, was well done. I have nothing really too bad to say about it. It felt like Star Wars. Like, I mean, what you see is what you get, really. but that's it. Seeing all these credits go by. Overall, if I were to give it like a letter or a number grade, let's say out of 10, I'm going to give it like 7 out of 10. Mediocre, middle of the road. Not overly stunning and overly great, but not by any means bad. Visually, it's eh. Gameplay-wise, middle of the road. Not great, but not horrible. The performance from the actors and stuff was really, and the story was really well done. I really want to see the aftermath of this. I mean, new trilogy aside, because I'm not a big fan of the new trilogy. I like Star Wars, but I'm not a big fan of the new trilogy. I'd really like to see where they're going to go from this point, you know, see what they're going to do. Yeah, that's kind of it. So just watch the rest of these credits and seeing all these people who did the technical work and stuff like that. I can't say they did a great job, but I can say that it was a decent experience. I'm curious as to if they're gonna add DLC to the game or if they're going to give us a new whatever. We'll just skip that because it's just credits and they're going to take forever. But that'll do it. Thank you guys for watching. And wow, not even like a bonus ending thing. Thank you guys for watching. If you are, I hope you're having a good day today. If you're not having a good day, hope tomorrow's better. And don't do anything I wouldn't do. This is Loneliest Pope signing out. I love your face. I just want to make sure you understand how much I do.